Just as running water and wind degrade and erode the landscape, transport material, and then deposit that material, and as a result of that, they also leave behind distinct landforms, so too glaciers do this. We are going to begin with the erosional degradational landforms. I'm going to give you a list of them and define them. These are going to be the ones that I want you to be responsible for. Then we're going to look at some diagrams that show these types of landforms, and we're going to look at real pictures of them. Here we go. The first one that I want you to be responsible for is a cirque. Remember, because the glaciologist who originally studied this was from Western Switzerland, the result is that a lot of the terminology is French. A cirque is a bowl-shaped basin formed at the head, which is the top of an alpine glacier. Bowl-shaped like what it sounds like it means, like a cereal bowl or a soup bowl. So it's concave. The head of the top of the glacier is the highest point in the mountains where the glacier originated. Because a cirque is indeed bowl-shaped, after the glaciers are gone and precipitation happens, a lake can form in this bowl-shaped basin. We call that type of a lake a tarn. Arête, or arêtes, if that's the way you want to say it, this is a French word. There's supposed to be a circumflex over that first E. Arêtes are sawtooth peaks that are formed between glacial valleys. So if you can imagine two glaciers running in parallel valleys with a mountain in between them, because of plucking and abrasion, the scraping and grinding of the glacier, what's going to happen is the mountain that's in between these two parallel glaciers will slowly be worn down and thinned out. The last thing that gets left at the top of the mountain is this ridge of these sharp sawtooth, like a serrated knife that you cut bread with, sawtooth peaks that we call arêtes. A horn, like the very famous Matterhorn, like the one in Anaheim, which is of course not real. A horn is a pyramid-shaped peak that's formed between multiple cirque glaciers. The main glacial valley, for that matter, all glacial valleys, but the main glacial valley is a U-shaped valley, like the letter U, because this is what it looks like in comparison to like the letter V, which is a river valley, or a U-shaped trough or a glacial trough. All of these are synonyms. They all mean the same thing. When you use them when you're talking about glaciers, everybody understands what you're talking about. This is a formerly V-shaped river valley that's been scooped out by glaciers, and as a result of that, takes on this distinct U-shape. A hanging valley is formed where tributary glaciers enter the main glacial trough. Because alpine glaciers go through valleys that were once river valleys, they have a kind of look like a river valley, so you may very well have a dendritic pattern. And with a dendritic stream pattern, you have the main river and then the tributaries that enter into that main river system. Well, this is what's going to happen with glaciers also, where you have a main glacier running through a valley and then you have tributaries. Those tributaries create hanging valleys. This is a pre-glacial landscape. I know this is an old school diagram, but a lot of times the old school diagrams are kind of better. And if you look, this is a series of river valleys, V-shaped valleys. You can see that there's this kind of V-shape, kind of dendritic pattern where the rivers are pouring into the main river system that you can see is going right through this area right here. That's the main river. And then you have all of these tributaries coming in. Once it's glaciated, so take a look at that. Once it's glaciated, you have the same system. You still have tributaries coming into the main system, but now it's all filled with glacial ice. And when you look at that, I've circled some things. The arêtes, you can see I circled in blue. Those are those sharp sawtooth peaks. Now it's all of these areas where you see the sawtooth peaks. It's not just right here. It's all of these areas here are all arêtes. Then a horn right there, the horn that I've circled in red. This is the pyramid-shaped peak that's formed between multiple glaciers. You can see there's glacier here, the glacier here. Probably on the backside there's glaciers. Then you see over here Cirque, right, that is circled in yellow. You know, it's only pointing at one right here, but all of these are all Cirque glaciers. All of these, even when it says Neve up here, all of these would all be making Cirques. Then you can see this area right here where the green arrow is at, that's the main glacial trough, just like it was the main river valley. Then each one of these are tributary glaciers coming in from the sides. That's indicated with the purple right there. That would be where a hanging valley is going to form. Take a look at this post-glacial landscape, which is what we operate with mostly. Remember, about 30% of the land area of the planet was once covered with glacial ice. We're down to 10%. So mostly we operate in a post-glacial landscape, but our job is to look at the landscape and figure out what had been happening there and what created these distinct landforms. Well, if you look at this, you can see Paternoster Lakes, which means a series of interconnected lakes that come down the mountain. Paternoster means our father in Latin. It's a reference to like rosary beads, because this is what it sort of looked like to the person who first described them. Then you can see where the cirques are at, which are these bowl-shaped basins up here, up here, up here, up here. There's going to be cirques. Then you see right here, we have a tarn, right? A tarn is a lake that's formed in a cirque, which very clearly this is a bowl-shaped basin. There would be tarns here too. Horn, formed between multiple cirque glaciers, pyramid-shaped peak. Then the arête, which are here, you can see these long lines of sawtooth peaks. These are all arête. Then here's the main glacial valley that they're calling this diagram a glacial trough, but you can see it's a U-shaped valley. Look at that, very U-shaped. Then you can see hanging valley. It's called a hanging valley because it just stops and then drops in the main valley. Oftentimes here, 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 you can see that waterfalls go over these hanging valleys. Let's practice a little bit, shall we? What are those white arrows pointing at? What are the white arrows pointing at? Take a look at that and tell me if you can see what they're pointing at. Answer is arête. Very good. Now take a look at this one. What are those orange arrows pointing at? There's really two things. Okay, one is the tarn. Very good. You see the lake there. And of course, tarns are formed in cirques, so it's also pointing at cirques. What about the red? Forget about the lakes. What's that area there? Like this area right here. What is this? That area right there. That is, of course, the U-shaped valley or glacial trough. What about that? The blue arrows? I know this is a little bit of a fuzzy diagram, but you know, we can deal with it. The blue arrows are pointing at hanging valleys. Excellent. And then the last thing, what's that purple arrow pointing at? That would be a horn. Very good. Now let's take a look at some real pictures. So the yellow arrow is pointing at the cirque, which is right here. You see there's still a glacier in there, but you can see it's a bowl-shaped basin. Okay. Then this is a tarn. Once again, if you look here, this is up at Convict Lake in the Sierra Nevada. Okay, if you look, this was a cirque right here. Very good. And then you can see there's a lake in this cirque, very famous fishing lake, stocked with rainbow trout. And if you have a lake in a cirque, that's a tarn. Then if you look, those orange arrows are pointing at that sawtooth ridge there. All those sawtooth peaks we call arête. Look at that. That's the most famous one in the world. That's the Matterhorn. There it is, on the border between Switzerland and Italy. So the Cirque Glacier would have been right here. Another one right here. Another one on the backside. You can even see there's a little bit of glacier still left here. And here, you see off in the background, there's still some glacial ice still here. But this would have been buried really right up to the top at one point during the greatest glacial advance during the Pleistocene. And then look right here. We've got Yosemite Valley, the great, glorious U-shaped valley or U-shaped trough. Look at that thing. Look at it. Woo, that's U-shaped. There was 3,000 feet of glacial ice going through that thing 30,000 years ago. Look at that U. That's it right there. Wow, what a valley. If you look at that one, okay, this is blurry because I was on a train in Switzerland when I took it, but look at that U-shape. Can you see that? Look at that U-shaped valley in the background right there. Wow, perfect glacial trough.